Hello dear students, myself Dr. Padmaja Kore from Department of Pharmacology, Progressive Education Society's Modern College of Pharmacy, Nigdi, Pune. In my today's lecture, I am going to cover drug distribution and the factors affecting drug distribution. Now coming to the definition of drug distribution, it refers to the movement of a drug to and from the blood and various tissues of the body and the relative proportion of a drug in the tissues. After the drug is absorbed into the bloodstream, it rapidly gets distributed throughout the body. Now these are some of the factors that affect distribution of drug. So these factors are divided into two types, that is factors related to drug and related to body. Now let us see what are the factors that are related to the drug. Lipid solubility, molecular size, degree of ionization, cellular binding, duration of action, therapeutic effects, toxic effects. These are some of the factors related to drug. Now let us see what are the factors related to the body. These are vascularity, transport mechanism, blood barriers, placental barriers, plasma binding of proteins, free and bound form of a drug, drug interactions, disease conditions, drug reservoirs and volume of distribution. So these are some of the factors that are related to the body. Now coming to the factors related to the drug, first and foremost important factor is lipid solubility. Greater the lipid solubility, more is the distribution and vice versa. Next factor is molecular size. Larger the size of a drug, less is the distribution, and smaller sized drugs are having more distribution pattern. Now coming to the next parameter, that is degree of ionization. Drugs exist as weak acids or weak bases when being distributed. Drugs are trapped when present in the ionized form, depending upon the pH of the medium. This fact can be used to make the drug concentrated in the specific compartment of the body. Coming to the next factor that is related to drug is cellular binding. Drugs may exist in free or bound form. Bound form of a drug exists as reservoir, and the free and bound form coexist in the equilibrium. Cellular binding entirely depends upon the plasma protein binding. Now coming to the next parameter, that is tissue binding. Different drugs have different affinity for different cells. All cells do not bind the same drug. Coming to the next factor, that is duration of action. The duration of action of a drug is prolonged by the presence of bound form while the free form is released. This leads to a longer half-life and duration of action of a drug. Next is therapeutic effect. Biophosphonate compounds bind with the bone matrix cells and strengthen them. They are used in treatment of osteoporosis. Coming to the next factor that is related with the drug is toxic effect of a drug. So there are some of the drugs which have got potential toxic effects. For example, chloroquine upon the repeated administration can be responsible for deposition into the retina. Tetracyclines can bind the bone material. It may also get bound to the enamel of the teeth. Now we will see the factors related to the body. The first important factor that is related to the body is vascularity. Most of the drugs passes through highly perfused organ, that is abound 75%, while the remaining 25% passes through less perfused areas. Therefore, most of the drugs go first to the highly perfused areas. They may get bound to these organs. Then, after that, they are getting redistributed to the less perfused areas like skin and skeletal muscles. Examples include thiopentone sodium, which is used as a general anesthetic. When given, it goes to the brain, producing its effects. It is then redistributed to less perfused organ. Because of high lipid solubility, it is accumulated in the fatty tissue for longer duration. Coming to the next factor related to the drug distribution is transport mechanism. Different drugs are taken up by different compartments of the body differently. Lipid-soluble drugs move by passive transport, which is non-specific. Active transfer occurs only where carrier proteins are present. Next factor of distribution related to the patient body is blood barrier. Different blood barriers exist. Blood-brain barrier is present because of the delicacy of nervous tissue to avoid chemical insult to the brain. Next factor that is present in the drug distribution related to the patient body is placental barrier. Trophoblastic tissue separates maternal blood from fetal blood. Different transporters are present there. Efflux transporters cause efflux back of the drug from fetus to the mother. Now, there is one more parameter, that is plasma protein bindings. Many proteins exist in the plasma. Plasma binding protein includes the most important protein that is involved in the binding is albumin. Albumin is the most abundant plasma protein. It has got higher affinity for acidic drugs, but capacity is low. However, albumin can bind a large number of basic drugs but has lower attractive forces. Its capacity for binding basic drugs is more, but affinity is less. Coming to the next protein involved in the binding is globulin. Globulin can bind hormones, vitamins, etc. Next is the glycoproteins. Alpha glycoproteins mainly bind basic drugs. Their levels are increased during stress, trauma, and surgery. It is during these times that their more amounts are required. Next is the lipoproteins. Lipoproteins also bind some drugs. Next factor is free and bound form of a drug. Most of the drugs after absorption from the gut are transported into free form and bind form. In case of free form, drug is solubilized in the plasma and transported. If the drug is in the bind form, it means that it is bound with plasma components like protein and blood cells, etc. Next important is drug interactions. Distribution interactions occur when drugs are extensively plasma bound and the co-administration of a second can displace it to the non-bound active form. This increases the amount of unbound drug that is available to cause the effect. Next factor is a diseased condition. Different diseases affect the distribution of a drug. Renal diseases causes hypoalbuminuria. due to less proteins, toxic levels of free drugs may be present. Uremic byproducts are also produced, which compete with the drugs. Hepatic diseases cause decreased synthesis of proteins, causing hypoalbuminuria. Free drugs may be present in toxic levels, and bilirubin byproducts increases as well. Thus, drugs who does have to be adjusted to produce desired effects may be reduced to even half. Next factor is a drug reservoir. Drugs are stored and are released slowly, which affects their pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. There are various drug reservoirs, including plasma proteins, liver, adipose tissue, bone, placenta, breast milk, transcellular fluid reserves, and some other body tissues like eye, kidneys, skeletal muscles, and skin. Now, coming to the concept of volume of distribution, assuming that the body behaves as a single homogeneous compartment with volume V, into which the drug gets immediately and uniformly distributed. Volume of a distribution, or apparent volume of a distribution, is calculated as the ratio of dose administered intravenous to the plasma concentration. Now, in this diagram, you can see 1000 mg of a drug is injected intravenously. It produces steady state plasma concentration of 50 mg per liter. In this case, the apparent volume of distribution by the above formula is 20 liters. There is one more concept, that is redistribution of a drug. Highly lipid soluble drugs get initially distributed to organs with high vasculature, means to the organs with high blood flow, that is brain, kidney, heart, etc. These organs are known as highly perfused organs. Later, less vascular but more bulky tissues like muscles, fats take up the drug and plasma concentration falls, and the drug is withdrawn from the highly perfused sites. If the site of action of a drug was one of the highly perfused organ, redistribution results in termination of the drug action. Greater the lipid solubility of a drug, faster is its redistribution. Now let us see the penetration of drug into the brain and cerebrospinal fluid. The capillary endothelial cells in the brain have tight junctions and they lack large paracellular spaces. Further, neural tissues cover the capillaries. Together, they constitute so-called blood-brain barrier. A similar blood-CSF barrier also exists and is located in the choroid plexus. Choroid plexus is a capillary network lined by choroidal epithelium with tight junctions. Both these barriers are lipoidal, and their main role is to limit the entry of non-lipid soluble drugs, for example, streptomycin, neostigmine, and etc. Only lipid soluble drugs, therefore, are able to penetrate and have action on the central nervous system. Now, as you can see, there are two diagrams, that is a usual capillary and brain capillary. Usual capillary with high paracellular spaces through which even large lipid insoluble molecules can diffuse. Capillary constituting blood-brain or blood-CSF barrier. Tight junctions between capillary endothelial cells and presence of glial process or choroid epithelium do not allow the passage of non-lipid soluble ions. So as you can clearly differentiate between usual capillary and brain capillary. In case of usual capillary, large lipid soluble or insoluble molecules can diffuse, whereas in case of brain capillary, it will not allow the passage of non-lipid soluble ions or molecules. There is one more concept, that is plasma protein binding. Most of the drugs possess physicochemical affinity for plasma proteins and get reversibly bound to these. Acidic drugs generally bind to plasma albumin, and basic drugs binds to alpha 1 acid glycoproteins. Binding of albumin is quantitatively more important. Extent of plasma protein binding depends on individual compound. For example, the binding percentage of some benzodiazepines is as: flurazepam binds to about 10% of plasma protein bindings, alprazolam binds to 70% of plasma proteins, lorazepam binds to 90% of plasma proteins, whereas diazepam it is binding about 99% to the plasma proteins. This is all about drug distribution. Thank you.